We're looking at this woman standing in the doorway, in between the inside and the outside. She is standing stiffly. We don't know who she is, but it's something about the way she's in the middle of this darker against the colorful outside. And this is also typical of the exhibition and why I chose this as the main painting for the exhibition with the title Yonder, Edvard Munch and Nature. We look at how Munch uses nature and how he deliberately includes it in most of his images and never just a coincidence or a backdrop. Here again, the landscape, we see it outside of the window, filling the whole background of the man who is Edvard Munch himself in the middle. This is a self-portrait from the early 30s. And again, he uses the landscape and he uses the colors of the landscape, the lilac, the whites, and how it almost drips down to the clothes of himself sitting there inside. So it's like almost they're becoming one in this one total atmosphere. Munch has painted many dark spruce forests. And here we see some of them, and we see how he uses the tall trees against the bluish, strong bluish sky. It's almost like a magical forest, and someone would probably say it's a typical Norwegian forest as well. Maybe when they look closer to the trees, and it's almost like you see the profile of trolls when you see the foreheads, the noses, the beard, and again in the second tree here. So it's something magical about the lightning in the middle and how it sets the atmosphere of the painting. Two children on the way to the Fairytale forest. Munchs take the children's perspective here in how we see the two children here in the forefront and how they are looking inwards the road and probably wondering if they should enter it. If we follow the load and the lines, we can also see how it builds up and we see similar trees, but this time it merges almost into this one big, huge, scary form. And at the top of it, we see this white cloud. Don't know what it is. And maybe the uncertainty also makes us believe or see that this wood does something organic or threatening. So the children should probably not enter this wood. The inner mood can also be seen here in a painting painted 40 years later than the previous one. But we can recognize elements which shows us how Munch reuses and experiments and continues to work with different compositions and the use of color to build up this mood and how he uses nature in doing it. Here it looks almost like it's painted spontaneously, very fast. We see the brush strokes moves. We see the dots We can also see how he doesn't wait until the paint dries. He let it slide down here, the canvas, and it almost resembles watercolors. And at the hillside, we can see some of the same, and it glides, and the hill is going through the whole forest scene here, almost resembling some kind of temple or larger building. And it's translucent at the same time, so it's again, it's some of the same magic, I think, we see in the fairy tale forest here. Now, moving on to the second and last room of the exhibition. This is the brighter and more lighter and vitalistic part. And here we see probably not typically Munch at all for anyone, not even me. I don't know if I've met or seen this somewhere else, I would have thought it was Munch. It's a very late work. And he painted it when he was almost 80 years old. And it has probably never been exhibited earlier either. So it's very nice to have the opportunity now to show it. And it's again fascinating to see how he uses new ways of reaching out when he works, and how he almost makes this abstract part in the painting, like the square-like yellow chest of the men and the sunbathing people at the back, made by simple dots by the brush. This much larger painting of a bathing man, made about 20 years earlier than the previous one, is a motif he works on actually for more than 40 years. He starts in the 90s and he continues all through his life. And he paints children, women and men. And after 1900, it became actually very popular doing this. It was a kind of vitalistic movement when it became popular to stay outside and be outside and be as one with nature. It was like it was an own force to it and to man. And in this motif, Munch has used the water, and he plays with the rhythm of the decorative parts of it. So it's almost like a, I don't know what you can call it, it's kind of backdrop, but a decorative big one. It's all abstract, and this with this mixture of coloring who makes it really, really strong against the naked standing man. And we know also that the bay is from Vidsten, where he had this summer residence just south of Oslo, where he had painted a lot of bathing motifs. And here at the end wall of the exhibition, I think we can call it the culmination of Munch's nature motifs when we talk about the energetic ones. And it's also the brilliant move he has done by focusing on the sun alone. It's nothing else. And he uses the colors, a lot of colors, and he filled the canvas, and he has again worked very fast, almost spontaneously, with long strokes. And we see the realistic element is not important here. It's more the energetic force of the sun, and we see the yellowish, blue, red, green, orange, all just spread out of the whole motif. And in the center, the sun, which has, in a way, its own force. It has, it's like a symbol of life. It's a symbol of enlightenment. But, and also, yeah, of course, compared to many of the other previous paintings we have seen, it differs as it's the sun alone, and we see that he let it be there, and he let nature be there outside in open air, and it lives on independent from man.